Let's start the first topic for this session. In this topic, we'll be seeing the various theories of dividend. We'll be studying two schools of thought, dividend theory of relevance and dividend theory of irrelevance. Now, various people came with various viewpoints. Are dividend actually necessary or not? Now, dividend relevance theory says the dividend decisions are very, very important. You pay dividend to a shareholder, you don't pay dividend to the shareholder, actually impacts the overall value of a shareholder. And it impacts the future profitability of the company. So there's two schools of thought in the theory of relevance. We have Walter's model and Gordon's model. Then we have irrelevance theory of dividend, which says that dividend decisions are irrelevant. You decide how much to pay to a dividend, whether you're paying dividend, you're not paying them dividend also, does not matter a lot. Then that we have is Modigliani and Miller approach. So we'll be starting first today is the theory of relevance, that is dividend relevance theory. Now, these theories argue that the dividend policy of a company affect the value of a firm. Remember, the goal of finance is the shareholder's value should be maximized, and this is what this theory talk about. There are two theories under it. We have Walter's model and Gordon model. Walter's model was actually propagated by James C. Walter, and Gordon model was propagated by Marion Gordon. We'll be starting first in this topic is the Walter model. Now, Professor James Walter argued that dividend policy always affect the value of the firm. See, what is our main? The goal of finance should be met. We study about investment, we study about financing, we study about dividend. At the end, what happens is the value of the firm should increase. So, Professor James says that, yes, dividend decisions, dividend policy affects the value of a firm. And how did he told that he tells about the relationship of two important factors in a dividend policy, rate of return and cost of capital. Now, according to the Walter's model, if the rate of return is more than the cost of capital, what happens? The firm is able to earn more than what the shareholders could get by reinvesting the money. Similarly, if the earnings are paid to them. Similarly, if the implication is that returns are more than the cost, returns means rate of return is more than the normal return you give to them. The shareholders earn a higher return by investing somewhere. Similarly, if your return is less than or equal to your cost of capital, it's a matter of indifferent whether earnings are retained or not. So, he told about two important things, whether rate of return and cost of capital. And rate of return is greater than cost of capital, rate of return is less than cost of capital, affects the distribution of dividend. And these two things actually take into account whether the value of firm will be increased or not. Now, there are certain assumptions which you need to keep under this model, that is, a firm uses only internal finance for its investing part, that is retained earnings. The firm does not use any debt, any equity to finance further. The firm has constant return and constant cost of capital. Remember, this theory is actually made into two factors, rate of return and cost of capital. So, assume both are constant. The firm has 100 recent payouts, so 100% is a dividend payout ratio. It has constant EPS, constant dividend, and the firm has a very long life. It is going to go on for a long period of time. Certain assumptions we need to understand is how this model, Walter model, actually comes into picture. We can help it with a small formula, which we actually need to find out the value of a share. So if a value of a share is increasing, and this Walter model was clearly, yes, dividend policy affects the value of a share. So how do you find out the price of a share under Walter model? So we take into account is the dividend per share. To it, you add up is your IRR, that is the rate of return, divided by cost. It is the cost of equity, multiply by EPS minus dividend per share. Similarly, divide the full equation by your cost of equity. This is how you find is under Walter model the price of a share. Let us do a small illustration to make it more clear. How do we actually find the value of a share or a price of a share under Walter model? Now, from the following information is available in respect of a company, they're giving you capitalization rate is 10%, earnings per share 50, rate of return on investment is 12%, dividend payout ratio is 20%. So how do you find the price of a share? Now, we take the first thing we need is a dividend per share. If you say dividend per share is how much given to us as dividend payout ratio is 20%, right? How much is earnings per share? 50. So 50 into 20% is how much? 10. So 10 is the dividend which is given. Now, if you see out of earnings, some amount is retained back, some is distributed in the form of dividend. So if earnings is 50, how much will be dividend per share? 50 into 20%, that is 10. So we got the first thing that is dividend per share, that is 10. Next thing we need is a rate of return. Rate of return is already given to us as 12%. Then we need to multiply with the difference between EPS and DPS. Earnings per share is 50, dividend per share is 10. Cost of capital is 10%. So multiply, divide the full equation by the 10% as R divided by K. At the end, the full equation should be divided by the cost of equity, that is 10%. If you solve this equation, how much you get the price of a share? We get the price of a share as 580. And that is what Walter Model told about. Walter Model gave a very important thing that rate of return and cost of capital are very, very important when you decide about the dividend relevance. Now, rate of return being more than the cost is very important because it ignores that the firm is able to pay more than what is expected by the shareholder and what the shareholder would get by reinvesting. Similarly, if normal earnings you pay to them, you're giving them more than the normal assets. That is, rate of return is more than the normal thing which you're getting. Remember, cost of capital, cost of equity should be equal to cost of retained earnings. But over here, giving them more than the normal expectations. So shareholders are also happy. Similarly, if rate is less than the cost of equity, then it's a difficult, and it's a matter of indifference whether the earnings are retained or distributed. This is what Walter's model talked about, and this is how you do under Walter's model, taking into account the various factors like earnings per share, dividend per share, rate of return, and cost of equity.